السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We present to you lesson number 1014 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today our focus is on Ahlu Baytin Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the household of the Master Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On one occasion, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha states, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emerged from the house and the Master alayhi salam was wearing a shawl, and Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu an and admitted him and placed him inside the shawl. Then Sayyidina Hussein, they were very young, the beloved grandsons of the Master alayhi salam. Thereafter Sayyida Fatima radiallahu anha came, and thereafter Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu came. Then the Master alayhi salam recited the verse of the noble Quran, Innama yuridullah liyudhiba ankum ar-rijsa ahla al-bayt wa yutahhirakum tathira. Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala's verdict is that is removing any impurity from you, O Ahlul Bayt, meaning that you are pure and Allah Ta'ala is purifying you. This is Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 33. And remember, this hadith is authentic in Sahih Muslim. Hence Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's beloved daughters, Sayyida Fatima radiallahu anha, Sayyida Umm Kulthum, Sayyida Zainab, Sayyida Ruqayya radiallahu anhunna, all of them are part of the Ahlul Bayt. And remember, the honorable wives of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are also part of the Ahlul Bayt. And Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on various occasions would praise them. On one occasion, Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu ta'ala was sitting on a minbar, and Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was addressing the people. Sometime the Master alayhi salam looking at the people, then paying attention to his beloved grandson, then said, Inna bani hadha sayyid, this grandson of mine is a leader. Allah Jalla wa Ala will use him to reconcile the Ummah among the Muslims. The hadith is mentioned in Bukhari Sharif, and this is what happened in the year 41. Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu ta'ala resigned, and after 6 months of the Khalifa, handed over the mantle of leadership to Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, who ruled this Ummah for approximately 20 years from the year 41 to 60. So we see that this is how unity was brought about. We see during the time of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, a person was in an ihram and he asked him that he killed a fly. So he asked him, from where are you? He said, from Ahlul Iraq. He said, today the people of Iraq are asking me, in ihram they killed the fly. وَقَدْ كَتَلُوا ibn binti Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are the same people who martyred the beloved grandson of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu an. And I heard the Master alayhi wa sallam saying, هُمَا رَيْحَانَيَّ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. They were my fragrance, they were my perfume, they were so special. Hadith in Bukhari Sharif. So therefore we need to understand there's a special rank for Sayyidina Hassan, Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu anhu, and the honorable wives of Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son-in-law, all of them. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam on one occasion made this dua for both of them, Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu anhu and Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu anhu, and said, Allahumma inni uhibbuhuma. Oh beloved Allah, I love both of them, Sayyidina Hassan and Sayyidina Hussein. Fahibbahuma, and you also love them. Wahibba may yuhibbuhuma, and love the person who loves them, O Almighty Allah. The hadith is mentioned in Tirmidhi Sharif. So therefore, we love the entire family of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Master alayhi salam said, Al-Hassan wal-Husayn Sayyida Shabab Ahlil Jannah. They are the leaders of the youth in Jannah. This is an authentic hadith in Tirmidhi Sharif. Sumar Ali Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about other members of the family. For example, Sayyidina Ja'far radiallahu anhu and said, Ra'aytu Ja'faran yatiru fil jannah ma'al malaika. Ja'far radiallahu anhu was martyred there in Mu'ta in the 8th year of the Hijrah. The Master alayhi wa sallam says, I saw him flying in Jannah with the angels. So we the Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uncles, Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, honorable wives and daughters and sons, and remember that the honorable son-in-laws, all of them form part of the Ahlul Bayt, the household of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Almighty Allah teaches us, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. That say, I don't ask you for any recompense and wages or salary, but you must love my kith and kin, my family. May Almighty Allah grant us His love, the love of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ahlul Bayt and the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Salaamu alaykum.